Welcome back for the next episode of playing Pokemon Shield to get the Electric Reggie. So, in this video, we'll be continuing on from the end of the introduction, which was the introduction of the gym leaders and the opening ceremony of the Pokemon Gym Challenge. So, let's get to it. As you can see, Nuzzle and Bite make a pretty good combo because sometimes when they are not flinching from Bite, they're paralyzed from paralysis. So, yeah. Sometimes an opposing Pokemon can go a whole battle without a single attack because of the combination. We'll be right back. Now, what I was actually doing at this point was looking for a specific Pokemon. One that I do find later, but it's a Pokemon that I was intending to capture specifically for the fifth gym, which is the Fairy Gym. And in my opinion, out of all the gyms, it is one of the hardest if you are not prepared for it. And I believe this is due to the fact that when Pokemon added the Fairy type, yes, Fairy has two weaknesses, which is Poison and Steel, that they also made a whole lot of other stuff weak to Fairy. So, Fairy is a bit on the powerful side because of the fact that it was a type added in much later than the others. So, there's a bit of a disconnect there, and if you are not prepared for the fight, then there is a good chance you will get stomped. For information, the reason that the game was paused just then was because I had been looking up the location of the Pokemon that I was trying to find. I believe at this point that I decided to go and find it later on, because the area was not going to be easy to get to at the moment, because there are areas that are blocked when you just start up a game. So you have to go through a certain area before you can get to the area where the Pokemon I wanted to catch was at. So, it was at that point that I decided I would add the Steel-types Clink to my party to work on powering it up for facing the Fairy Gym. The Pokemon I was originally searching for does spawn in this area, but it's a very rare spawn, so I was doing a respawn on the Pokemon a few times to hopefully make said Pokemon spawn. But I don't catch it here, and I do eventually catch it later on. Point. I knew that the nuzzle wouldn't do any damage, but I had been hoping that possibly it would still do the paralyze effect, but it didn't do anything at all, so yeah, there's that. Now, there's actually a trick to the buried trees. If you watch the top leaves a bit, you'll see there's a little bit of a gap between when the leaves shake. But when it's shaking nonstop and there is no gap, that's when you stop. Otherwise, you will be attacked by a Pokemon from the tree, which will then steal some of the berries that fall from the tree. And we get the evolution to Drizzle, which, in my opinion, is a bit emo-looking, but it's all the way to the final evolution that I go, because that is the most effective of this evolutionary line. Well, this video is starting to get a little long, so I'm going to cut it off once I reach the lady at the entrance to the cave. She works like a Pokemon Center. If you talk to her, she'll hear your Pokemon. And there's another one at the exit of the cave as well. So once I talk to the Pokemon Center lady, this video will be over. And that's it for this one. So thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it.